My husband and I were ready to start our family, and it was January 12th, and we were going to a concert that night, and my period was due that day, and I had a feeling that day that I was pregnant. I just kind of knew that I was pregnant. I took a pregnancy test that night since we were going out, and it was positive, and we were going to keep it a secret for as long as we could. And that was January 12th of 2013, and we were just expecting this to be the best year of our lives because we were going to have our baby. So September 12th of 2013, I was 39 and a half weeks pregnant, had gone into labor. We went into the triage room, and me and baby are doing great. My daughter's doing great. So we are on our way up to the delivery room, and somewhere in between there, just within a matter of minutes, our daughter went into distress and her heart rate was dropping. And they said that if they couldn't get her heart rate up, that I would have an emergency C-section, which I did. What I hear is that my husband collapsed in the hallway, and I could hear everyone crying in the hallway. And initially it sounded like a joyous cry, and then I realized that it was a sad cry. And that was how I knew that my daughter didn't make it. It was everyone's reaction that I heard from the hallway. When they told me that I would have an emergency C-section, I was, you know, it wasn't my plan. I wanted to have this natural pregnancy, but I never thought for a second that my daughter wouldn't make it. We were shocked. The first couple weeks were just the worst. It was, I can't even describe it. It was awful. It was just awful. I can't imagine ever having to go back and live through those first few weeks again. Well, because the hardest part for us to return to normal was that Eleanor was our first child, so we didn't have that opportunity to be parents yet. We didn't know what it was like to be parents, and here we were waiting for our first daughter, and we're childless. We were gonna try again for another baby, and we were very fortunate in that a year and a half later, we were blessed with our son, Luke, and 10 weeks ago, we had another little girl named Hannah. So we feel incredibly lucky to have two living children. So we have three total, but only two with us.